All right, with us now, CNN military analyst and former NATO Supreme Allied Commander General Wesley Clarke. General, I want to start with Al-Shifa. We were just hearing about that right there. Let me just read you this latest CNN report as you locate that on the map. A U.S. official with knowledge of the American intelligence says Hamas as a command node under that hospital and uses fuel intended for the hospital and its fighters, and the fighters regularly cluster around that hospital. So that information from a U.S. official, as we're getting new video from the IDF of the Al-Quds hospital. That's a hospital nearby. It's no longer operational, but there are still people inside waiting to be evacuated. And you can see in this footage from the IDF what they have circled and identified as a terrorist with an RPG launcher at the front door of the hospital, going in and out of the hospital. So, General, if you will, just talk about this. Talk about how Hamas uses these structures and how that complicates Israeli efforts in the region.
Well, this is a long-developed plan by Hamas to use international laws of land warfare against the Israelis to be able to bring global pressure against the Israelis when they retaliated. So the tunnel network has been built according to all the information that's been made public so that its centered node is under these hospitals. This is where the nexus of the tunnel network is. And Hamas did this deliberately. Now, from the Israeli perspective, they are under international law, so they have to protect humanitarian facilities. They cannot bomb hospitals. They have not bombed this hospital, but they do have the right to self-defense. And they are going to have to go into these hospitals and get into those command nodes. Maybe the command nodes will have been evacuated by then. But there is a fight for this, and there is a concern about this by the Israelis to try to avoid the global implications of what they're doing. But they're still bound by the laws of land warfare. So you have one side that's legally trying to deal with an enemy. You have the other side, which is cynically exploiting international law to put its own people at risk and use them as hostages. That's what this is really about, John.
Yeah, and again, because you see the images like the ones of the babies from the neonatal unit there out of the incubators here being warmed by tinfoil and water here. And these are images that Reuters has provided, but that do some work for Hamas so people can see what's happening in the hospital. And people are suffering inside there, General.
It's terrible, really, condition, and it is the fault of Hamas. Under international law, Hamas should have no military operations, no defense of that hospital. Get away from it. Leave the doctors and patients there. The Israelis will come in, provide security for it, and pick up the medical responsibilities. That's what should be happening. But as long as Hamas is using it as a base of operations, it's going to be very difficult for Israel to get in and assume the humanitarian responsibilities that it must, under international law, assume.
Let me ask you very quickly what has been happening in Syria, because a new round of U.S. strikes took place in eastern Syria, and we've seen attacks before from the U.S. on targets that it says are used by Iranian proxies in that part of the country to attack U.S. interests. What's happening here?
So this is an effort again by the United States to strike back at Iran, who's the source of the problem, without escalation. So it's a balance between hitting the forces, hitting the command nodes, hitting the logistics that are supporting the attacks on the American forces without going to the source and without escalating. But this is a slight escalation, John, because as I understand it, we're not just hitting the militias out there, we're actually attacking some Iranian Revolutionary Guards components there in Syria. So we're actually going after Iranians who are in Syria. So this represents a slight escalation.
And bears watching. General Wesley Clarke, always great to have you. Thank you very much.